Good evening, everybody. This is B-Run, and this is our Final Fantasy VI hacking first thing we're going to do here with streaming. Yeah, this is going to be interesting if anybody shows up. If not, you can see how lonely I was on YouTube. Yeah, it's time to do this. We're going to be working on a desperation hack today. Working out the desperation system for Final Fantasy VI. It was a little known feature. Hey, Mad, good to see you. Let's see. Anyway, so the desperation system kind of flew under the radar. It was very rare, and there wasn't a whole lot you could do to control it, other than put yourself at barely any health and hope beyond hope that you got an attack off. And so it wasn't very useful. And so we were looking at ways that we can make this better. And I thought it would be interesting to make it a community project, but not just through the forum working stuff out, but on Twitch. Because why not? Why not? Why not? So that's what we're going to do. So far, it is just me and Matt, which is fine, because we could totally handle this ourselves. But we have a couple other people that are hopefully showing up a little bit later for what will probably be the most boring channel on Twitch. Yeah, we'll fill up the chat by ourselves. We'll make it look like it was busy. Yeah. Rah. Okay. Score. Actually, this is going to be pretty casual. There's not like a set plan in place. I have some basic information that I looked up and some stuff to keep us moving along, but nothing too set in stone. So we'll see what happens. And if it doesn't catch on, then it doesn't catch on. But let's hope it does. All right. Well, there's no reason to sit around and do nothing. So that way when people show up late, they feel bad because we're actually in the middle of stuff. For those of you who see this later on YouTube, this is what I use. Notepad++. Bam. This is what I use. Notepad++. HXD is my hex editor. Geiger's SNS9X debugger, which we're using a lot of, but we had some problems in testing with it crashing a little bit, but we're not going to be doing too much in there, at least nothing extended, so we shouldn't have too many problems with that. There's potential for using FF3 USME if we decide we're going to be making this HP-based. We may need to find ways to get us down to just a little bit of HP very, very quickly so that we can be testing this. We're going to be working with opcodes, which you can look up here. And the documents we'll be using are likely to just be the C1 bank, the C2 bank, and the RAM map. All that stuff will make sense when you look at it. Anyway, for anyone who's been around hacking, most of the stuff will look familiar to them. Anyone who hasn't, we're going to be working through all of this step by step, so you shouldn't have too hard a time picking it up as we go. So the first thing that I was looking into is just trying to come up with a goal, figure out what it is that we're actually trying to accomplish. So I took some screenshots of the menu so we can see what it looks like currently and what things we might potentially want to change and how we might want to change it. Any work we do in C1, which is the display part of the battle system, is going to require a fair amount of work. So we're not doing anything too crazy. We're not adding a fifth menu option. We're not going to be doing anything totally off the wall. We're going to be trying to find out what we can do to work with the system that's in place to make something that the player might have a little bit more control over, or at the very least know what it is that they're doing or what's about to happen to them. So a lot of the suggestions that we had on the forum were to go very similar to the Final Fantasy VII system, the limit system. So I'm not totally against that. That's something that we could definitely look into. There's not quite room for two gauges on the ATB bar. But again, we could do away with ATB because the second setup doesn't use ATB at all. It uses current HP and max HP. So we could use either of those setups. We could use either of those setups and find a way to fit it in there. So we could hypothetically use the bar instead of the ATB bar as the limit bar. We could use a bar over here, so they could have a choice between their ATB bar and their limit bar. We could have a choice between their ATB bar and a percentage of limit instead of the max HP. So there's a number of different things we can do, and we can figure out exactly what it is we want to do. I even had an idea, potentially, just having your name or your HP slowly change color as you get closer to hitting the limit break. but that would depend on what we can do with the palettes. So there's a little bit of stuff to work out for this. As far as actually selecting, coming from the menu, we could either have it replace attack, which is an okay idea, but for a lot of physical setups, your limit being a single hit attack could potentially reduce your DPS if you're using a setup like with the Genji Glove or with the Offering. And so you could be using that and then all of a sudden have a turn where you have to use your Desperation Attack. So I kind of like the idea of making the limit optional. Name in red or green when limit is reached. Yeah, see, exactly, something like that. Something like that. Or even something similar to Final Fantasy VIII is when you reach your limit, you get a little arrow or something that shows you to move over to the next menu over. Because I wouldn't have necessarily a problem replacing row or defend with desperation. So we could do something like that. Let's take a look at the actual code. So for the desperation, if you pull up your C2 disassembly, or just look at mine, we're gonna go ahead and find, and we're just gonna look up desperation and see what happens. So when you pull it up here, first thing that pops up. So this is talking about. This looks like a branch for commands. Let's look around. Desperation attack. Okay. This is the actual calculation it does to figure out whether or not you're going to be using your desperation attack. So it's going to go down the characters, or, you know, find your character, go down and figure out if you're eligible for the attack. And then, if you are, there's a random chance that you'll actually do it. So it takes out things if the character that's attacking is a monster. If they're not near fatal, then they can't do it, then it branches out. If they're muddled or image, really? Can't do it if you're image? Huh. I wonder if that was supposed to be imp. I have to take a look at that. But people who are looking at this for the first time probably won't be able to understand a lot of what they're looking at right here. What do you mean, fight reach that block first? My guess is that, and I haven't looked at it yet, my guess is that when you select fight, it's going to run this code before it determines whether you're fighting or not. it goes down the code, and so long as you don't meet the conditions or you fail the roll, it'll stay on fight. Whereas if you meet the conditions and you get the 1 in 16 chance for Desperation Attack, it'll change your attack to the proper Desperation Attack. Yeah, okay. That's what I thought. And I didn't see anything. That just makes sense based on the way the game works, because it replaces fight randomly when you meet certain conditions. So that's basically what I'm guessing is happening here. Now, we could always go and test that later, but for all intents and purposes, it doesn't matter that much. We do incidentally need to find out where it is that it's sent there from, so that we know if we need to skip that and then call this code at a later time. I'd like to keep most of our calculation, if we're going to do any calculation at all, in this block right here. I don't want to go too far outside of this, because I'd like this to be a patch that could be used in other patches, in other game hacks. That's a great idea. That is a great idea, just so we can see what we're doing here. All right. Incidentally, where does it check the character? So I think I need to get no if monster, no if counter is 767 or less, time counter. Actually, I don't know what that is. I don't know what that is. Is that? That can't be that it only happens in like a battle counter extremely late in the game, in the fight. I'm gonna have to look at that. Matt, if you know off the top of your head. If not, you might have to look it up. All right, what I need to do here, but for what we're doing about doing it 100%, for doing it at 100%, what we'll need to do is we can actually change this. So this opcode right here is branch if equal. And what it's doing is it's testing for, and I'm a little bit rusty, but it's testing for the 0 bit in the processor. And let me actually show you what I'm talking about here. When you have the debugger up, the processor has a number of different statuses that it can have on it. So if we go ahead and run the game, it's going to be the CPU has a number of states that it has at any given time. It's got a number of registers. I'm going to go over this pretty quickly because I want to keep it mainly to the hack right now. So down here, the processor is going to have has an accumulator, which is basically the number that it's currently working with. There's an X register and a Y register, which are basically other variables that you can use in your processing. The accumulator is the main one, and that's what most of the opcodes use when it's checking things, when it's doing things. And then X and Y, basically you set as temporary variables or counters or other things. And then there's a number of different flags on the processor, and I'm trying to remember where those are on here. And maybe I should have gone through this a little bit more. Maybe I should have. It should be. It's going to show hex. No, that's not it. That's not it. Well, this was less helpful than I had hoped. Essentially, there's a flag. Edit registers, is that the one? That sounds right. That sounds right. Ha, thank you. Thank you. Okay. So, this stuff is a little bit more advanced, but the main thing you need to, that we're talking about right here, is most of the branches are based off of these flags here. And they all have different meanings for the processor and what it's working with. The most common ones that are used are the carry, and zero, and occasionally negative or overflow. I mean, all of these get used, but the ones that you're going to be actively thinking about when you're hacking are these ones here. So branch of equal is checking this zero flag, which is basically either when the accumulator is zero, or if two compared things are the same, if there's zero difference. I believe that's the case. It might be, no, yeah, I'm pretty sure that's it. So anyway, what it's doing is it's checking this flag right here. And so what it's doing is when you're comparing, if that zero flag was set, then it's going to branch this many bytes. And this is going to be in hex, and this is not going to be a hexadecimal tutorial. But this is branching forward 36, and that's not actually 36, that's hex 36, which is a very different number that I don't know off the top of my head, but that's what Windows Calculator is for. You can actually put this in Programmer and pop into hex 36 and decimal, so you're jumping ahead 54 bytes. No, no, we don't have all night. We're not doing hex. Anyway, so what I'm going to do is instead of comparing it to see if it's zero, and basically it's checking a bit right here that was loaded into this right here, loaded into the accumulator. So this is load accumulator, and this is an address with an offset of the Y register. So it goes to the 3EE5, and then it jumps forward Y more bytes. So that's what that's doing right there. And it's going to load that number, whatever number that is, in the RAM to the accumulator. And then it's testing this bit right here. And so when it tests that bit, it's either going to set that zero flag or not set the zero flag. If the zero flag is set, then it's going to branch. All right, so that was a long description. Yes, exactly. 3EE5 plus Y. All right, so what we're actually going to do while we're doing this testing phase is we're going to change this to basically to always branch. And so to do that, we're going to go ahead and bring up the opcodes that I showed you guys over here. We're going to find out what that is. There we go. And let me bring a window over here. Let's see if I can make this more intelligible. All right. So we're looking for branches. This is all the branches right here. And we just want to always branch, which is 80. So always branch right here. So what we're going to do back over here is what we want to do is we're going to change this to 80. Now we actually need to find this in the hex. Anyway, this. All right. More hex stuff. Okay, I keep headers on all my stuff. So, get over it. And we're going to jump to this address here. We drop the C because that is the, if I remember correctly, the high ROM address, and we just need the absolute, I don't remember all the terminology. I'm definitely the person that should be doing this. Okay. So instead of C2, we're just going to have 2. And then it would be 15D8, except because I've got this 200 byte header, and that's hex 200, we're going to add 2 to this. So we're going to 217D8, and that'll jump us to this C215D8. All right, so jump in there, and you see we're at FO36. All right, so we're just going to go ahead, and we're going to change that to 8036 for testing, okay? And while I'm at it, I'm going to create another tab here, and I'm going to copy this whole thing, and I'm going to keep track of our edits. Okay, yeah. All right, so this is Desperation Plus. And the one we changed here, and it's good that it checked for this. This is the one we're changing right here. And ultimately, this isn't going to be the actual hack, but just so that we have something to go back to. See? There's reasons for this stuff. All right, now let's go to the rest of the stuff. I don't know about this timer, so actually what I'm going to do is I'm actually just going to go ahead and branch always for this also. I do not know what that timer is. It's 903D. Yeah, that's right there, so we're going to change that to 803D. We don't want monsters doing attacks. If it tried to calculate it, it would come up with something totally wrong. Am I? Oh. Yeah, you're right. I just need to branch past the next opcode. Thank you for catching that. I would have caught that my first round through. You have to let me make some mistakes, okay? Because, come on. All right. So, either I could just blank all this out to not process, but what I'm actually going to do is just have it branch always, but just to the next bit of code. So instead of 903D, we're actually just going to jump. Actually, not at all. 00. So yeah, I could just not process that out. Yeah. Because it's just checking this. And checking this. This one I want to leave in. Alright, yeah. Alright, so we're going to skip that. We're going to skip that. Clear zombie, not doing that. Alright, so what's B9? What is B9 in there? I want to at least take a look and see what it is. So I'm hopping over to the RAM app. Going down, and of course it's not there. Of course it's not in the RAM map. So we might have to figure that out, or for the time being, skip it. But just as a matter of an exercise, I'm going to hop back over to the C2 code here, and I'm going to do a search for this B9 to see if I can figure out what's going on, figure out what it's doing. So, control find for what? B9. And it's going to wrap around. Okay, good. Let's go up first. All right, so what are we storing in B9 here? Zinger. Let's see what else stores 0, B9. I think B8 and B9 might have something to do with targets, like who's acting. And so B8's targets, B9 I believe is who is doing the action, so the caster. That's what that looks like, at least based on what I'm looking at right here. So that's clearing stuff out. get targets from B8 or B9. Maybe it's second byte of target. Yeah. Oh, I see. Because if it's because if we're using the 16-bit accumulator, then B8 and B9 would both be targets. That's right. Because one of them ends up being monsters, and one of them ends up being no. Is that right? I don't know. It's 8, 4, possible up to 6 monsters. So that's 12. Yeah. So you definitely need 2 bytes for that. Yeah. Yeah. That makes sense. See, this is why it's a team effort. And so, what are we checking? Either this is no available targets, or that might be no available targets. I mean, it definitely can't do it if you're attacking one of your own characters. But I don't think that's what it's doing right here. Because it wouldn't be checking if it was 0, it would be checking if it was a bit in a specific place. In the house. Clever. Clever. Good, it's super exciting, I can tell. All right. So we're going to leave this in because we think this is targets, random number generator. One in 16 chance. So branch if not equal. But this is really what we're going for right here. So this is really where we want to jump when we get down to this last thing. So this one, I think we want to leave in place. And then after that, we're going to skip all this. We're going to skip all this. So this, this we're leaving in place. So this JSR, I think, we're just going to branch forward or just not process it out. Sure. Sure. Let's knop it out. So starting with 25A4B. Where am I going? E9. Right here. All right. So we don't want to run that. We don't run on that. And we don't want to run that. And so. And that's where we want to get. All right, so we skip that one, we skip that one, we skip all that. Right? Skip this, skip this, skip this. Go straight to the load. This is the last one we're actually checking for. This one we checked, this one we checked, this one we skipped. This one we skipped. All right, that should be everything. That should allow us to do a desperation attack every time. So now I actually need to get past. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and save this, and we're gonna launch the game. And silly me, I did not create a load that was outside of a Magitek armor. So we might have to rush ahead. Hopefully I'm not spoiling the story for anybody. You know, I just realized that I had a lot of crashes on this. So I'm probably going to be saving state pretty often. Yeah, I don't have any save states that are... I could probably grab one from somewhere else. But I don't know where I've got one for this. What am I doing? What am I doing? Oh, actually, you know what might be a better idea? Here. Let's go ahead and save that. And I will just grab a random. Let's do this. Do I have save RAM? Desperation Plus. All right. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna launch it in ZSNS. Can you guys hear that okay? I kind of muted it for myself so I wouldn't get any feedback. Ah, thanks, Mad. Oh, no. No, that didn't get anything. Because if it had... Did I spell it wrong or something? Desperation? Hey, which way is it spelled correctly? I don't know. Is it desperation or is it desperation? Apparently it's desperation in this. But I thought it's desper. Spell check. Gotta have a save in here somewhere. No? No! Why is this not working? Oh, wait, did I? No, I did close it. I did close it. Desperation. You know what? I'm going to grab one of those saves. First save point. No, I don't want that. I don't want to. All right. Grab this God mode save. Extract all files. Sure. Actually, let's do this. Bing, 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 bing. Bing, bing. Alright, get rid of that. Oh, I might just use that save state. Here. Fortunately, hacking ends up being a lot of this. A lot of clicking around, so I hope you weren't coming for something very flashy. Alright. So I was supposed to have... supposed to be outside of the mines. Supposed to be the... I grabbed the wrong one, didn't I? Score. Score. South Figro. We're going to grab South Figro and do the same thing we just did. Only this time I'm going to cop... not that. Grab this address. I don't need this anymore. Extract all to that place. There we go. Alright, get rid of this. Those two. And we're going to rename these. Oops. Desperation Plus. Desperation Plus. Here we go. Here we go. Alright, so let's see if we can get ourselves 100% chance of Desperation Attack. Let's see if we did that right. Hey, Mirager, okay. And Riot Blade, alright. I think we got ourselves 100% there. So mission accomplished. hacking works. Oh, wait. Ho, ho, ho. There's a check. There's a check to only happen once per fight. I forgot about that. That's another thing to disable. Hacking works, but not always the way you think it's gonna. Hey, Funky Disco. All right. Where are we going? Where are we going? So where do we have... So there's got to be a check somewhere to make sure that we haven't done this before. Let's go back to C2. No, because I not processed, I knocked that out, that first one. Where am I at? I'm not even in the right place. It is desperation. I was right. It can't be the timer because I knocked that out. Yeah, there's currently one DA per fight, and I did notice that when I was going through. When I was, you know, previewing some of the stuff for the stream tonight, and I don't remember where it's at. But I remember seeing that. So none of those are it. None of those are it. There must be one more down here. Or there's something that skips this. So let me find out where it jumps here. That's what we're going to do. We're going to see where we jump to 15C8. And we're going to go up. Really? Really? Then it must be in a branch. It must be in a branch instead of a JSR. But even then, the annotation should have the right place. Yeah. Yep. All right. What's the next place it goes to? If it's wrong, where's it jumping to? Where do we find out? It's jumping to 610. Jumping down to 610. Let's find out what else calls this. Because that would be where it was skipped to. Nope. All right, it's got to be sitting right in front of me then. It's got to be here. What do we got here? C215F3. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So what it's doing... Test and set bit. Branch not equal. 610. Yeah, exactly. It was right in front of me. How did I not see that? All right, so I just need to knock this out. Which is right after the load. Okay. So it was literally like right in front of us. Okay. So we'll let it set the bit. Actually, those bits might be usable later, so I want to keep track of that and see if those are used anywhere else, because that might be something we could potentially use as part of the whatever system we end up putting in place if we need some RAM. It's a very, very small amount, but we'll see. All right, so that's this right here, DO18. DO18. That right there. Alright. Knob it. Knob it. Alright. No, wait. Not from there. I could do it from here. That's fine. That's not the one. Where am I running from? What game am I running? Nobody look at that. Desperation. What? Are you using a different thing? I don't need you anymore. Go away. This data. Alright, let's try that again. Let's try this again. Wham! I like how it pushes them back. You don't really see that in a lot of animations. Alright, moment of truth. Bam! Now we have 100% riot desperation attack. Alright, so we know how to make it happen. So we went through all of that just to kind of get a handle on what was going on, because the code at the end probably isn't going to look very much like that. But we do want to see what it is we're working with. We see what it's looking at, we see how it's looking at it, and we're seeing what it does with it. It also gives us some addresses that we're working with. So one of the things that we pointed out that we wanted to look at was this 3F2F bit. And I want to see if we have something on the RAM map for that. If there's anything tied to it other than just desperations. What was it? 3F2F? Scroll down. Okay, so we actually got a nice big space here where they don't know what's going on. Let me go back in here. I'm using this SRM here. Hypothetically, I should be able to. Unless I'm wrong, an SNS9X uses a different save. Do they use a different save format? Is it like .save or something? Like, why am I not getting my save from that on here? Because this is where I need to get it for my debugger. I have to grab a save from somewhere else. Alright. So what I need to do is grab the save RAM, and there should be this here. I told you guys I'm a bit rusty. It's been a while since I did most of this stuff. Alright. Now we're in business. Bing. Oh. Why is... Alright, my keybinds are all messed up. That's weird. Input. WSAD. BA. Yeah, that should be right. Shouldn't have anything else. These need to get disabled. Goodbye. That's all that was. Okay. There we go. Alright, so what I want to do now that I'm in here, I want to show my hex. I want to look at the RAM. And this 7E bank is the RAM. And where we were looking was 3F2F, right? 3F2F? Yep. So we're going to come back over here. 3F, 2F. All right, so we see that those are all currently zero. All right, and we should see, yep, see how we got one changed up here, changed to one. That means, that's basically telling me that probably Terra, I think it's probably based on the character, or the actor, excuse me, not the character in battle. I could be wrong about that, but I think when it's characters from battle, it goes from bottom to top, but I might be totally wrong about that. Let's see what happens when Loctus hits. Is it going to go to... Oh, yeah. Alright, and then, yeah, you see it sets back to zero. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to move them down to the bottom and see what it does. And it's using that RAM for other stuff here, so that means it's not a permanently savable place also. Alright, so now when Terra does it, it's 8. Okay, so it is based on their spot, and then it should change to C. Yeah, okay. So, what this just told me, for anyone who's looking at this later, pause, is that when you have four characters here, there's a bit for each one of them. And so there's the 1-bit, the 2-bit, the 4-bit, and the 8-bit. At least those are what they work out to be in decimal. And so the byte, the value of the byte, is based on how many bits are on. So let's go back to the calculator. So you saw that first time that we ran through, first thing it did was change to 1. So if we look at that in binary, it's just 1. Okay? And then it changed after Locke did his to 3. Look at that in binary, it's 1, 1. So the first bit's on and the second bit's on. Alright, then when we came through and did it again, Terra did hers, and it changed to 8. So 8 in binary, so you see this here would have been character 1 if there was a character 1, this was character 2 if there was a character 2, character 3 here is Locke, and character 4 is Terra. So as soon as she, so when she went to go do hers, it set the bit. Alright, and then Locke did his, and it changed to C. Go to binary, C. Bit 4 is on, bit 3 is on, and then bit 2 and 1 are both off. So, in hex, that translates to C. So that's how it's keeping track of that. And we also learned that this RAM gets used outside of battle as well. So that means it's not a permanently savable location for limit breaks. If we do, like, a limit type system, where we have a charging bar. So that's a little discouraging. I'm not sure I'm up to finding free RAM anywhere currently, so we might have to get creative with that. Does that make sense out to everybody? Are you guys following what I'm saying here? I think the people that are on are picking up what I'm putting down. Incidentally, I'm a network engineer, and I have to know the binary in my head. I still do it with the calculator, though. But anyway, so we just found out a few more stuff for our hack. We found out that there's a little bit of RAM used for the desperation attacks, and we also know that we can't take it outside of battle. So at this point, we're kind of at the point where we've kind of discovered what we're looking at. Sure, go for it. Yeah. This was like 2% plan, Matt. I had a topic and I had done a search on the C2 bank for desperation. That was my preparation. All right, so what's this Esper byte we're talking about here? I'd like to know. Unfortunately, because of the delay, it means I'm going to be sitting here for a second while I wait. Finish my glass of wine. Tell me about this idea. Really? Red wine, I'd say it's for my heart, but it's because I like it. All right. Now, are we talking about, like, when, like, what Esper is being learned from? Okay, I would thought maybe it was what Esper is currently equipped as far as when it's doing the attack. Oh, hey, Gene Attack. Welcome. All right. Well, let's, now, is this, is it only used, see, that's, so that's the question, if it's, it needs to be a byte for the characters that we can take outside of battle. And incidentally, it might make more sense if we have one per actor. So for each person, whether they're in the party or not. Or if we stick with something that's in the party, when they leave the party, they lose all of their limit break, which would be fine. But then we also have to make sure we're accounting for when you move party members around to make sure the code knows to switch those two values. So it ends up being a little bit of extra calculation. It is outside of battle, but it breaks the Esper system. Yeah, we would like to keep this in place. It's one per the 16 slots. Yeah, we'd like this hack to be as non-invasive as possible. So we're trying to get a hack together that has as small an impact on the code as possible. Like, I would like to keep as much of it as possible in here. And if we're doing something with more control, then it'll be a little bit easier to skip a lot of this stuff, which would make it easier to keep inside of here. But we don't want to be jumping too much into empty space because so many other hacks use all that empty space. Like, there aren't very many hacks now that are just text or just sprites or whatever else. Like, most people who are making hacks these days are actually using this free space with other hacks, or, you know, with other patches or with their own work. So we need to find something that's non-invasive and that's not going to break other parts of the game. So so part two of this may be end up being after we come up with a little bit more of a plan. Today looks like it's becoming more of a discovery phase. But it's okay, that's how this works. That is how this process works. I hope people were not coming on here hoping we would have a finished patch at the end of an hour and a half, because that would be like the fastest patch I ever put out ever. So we need to find some space, and we need to find come up with a plan of action. Let's go back to, since we're at kind of a standstill here for the moment, let's go back to the display and figure out what we want to do with this. Oh, Tenka's here. Welcome. Nope, it started an hour earlier than right now, unfortunately. 9:30 Eastern Standard Time. Sorry for the confusion, Denko. In the future, it was suggested that I get a counter, so I will look into that, even if it's just like on Google, just a little counter that'll pop up, so that way people can check on. I'm getting worldwide appeal. That's how we're spinning this. This is worldwide coverage. Yeah, Eastern Standard is on UTC minus 5 right now. Yeah, I think Mad and oh, that's weird. I thought you were in another location. Did you move? Gain attack? By the way, I'm not using first names on here. Just even if I know them, I'm not using first names on here. I do remember the sword tech names, but that's the first thing everyone goes for. So I'm a little hesitant. We may end up doing that. We may end up doing that. I'm a little hesitant though, just because that's the first place everyone goes for free RAM. Whoa! Well, I appreciate the dedication. I am recording all of this, so you will be able to come back and see what we did already. Yikes. Yikes. Is there such thing as reverse swatting for Twitch? Yeah, and I'm also looking at potentially having a number of other conditions, or maybe per battle. Like, there's a lot of different ways we can look at this. I figured. Anyone who tried it, I'm sure would get some random person who would be very angry. Anyway. So it looks like we're gonna end up revisiting this next time for sure with a plan of attack. But for the time being, we figured out where it is, how to make it happen all the time. At the very least, we could increase the percentage and have like a first draft that happens above near critical or near fatal, excuse me. And I don't remember where near fatal is set, but we can get rid of that. And then either adjust the chances if you guys wanted to have something for tonight. Make it a bar and fill it. Okay, we have a proponent for the limit system. That's what everyone seems to be going for. I guess that's what we'll end up doing, because everyone else is doing that. Yeah, 75% on any attack. Be pretty easy. We just do the random number. And then adjust this right here. Well, see, it would be because everyone understands that, but that the limit system has a lot of other things that we need to tap into. So since we only have about half an hour left, let's stick to the formula that's in place and tinker with it. Okay, so next time we come back, we'll do something more in depth. And anyone who's on the forum, which is probably everyone here, I don't know. if you're not or ff6hacking.com, that place is where we're have the where we will have the discussion on this. So for tonight, since we have half an hour, let's figure out something we can set up for this, just so we can have a patch to throw out there and be like, hey, we made desperation attacks happen more often, and we did it on a live stream, and if you want to be part of our next stream and our next patch, come and visit us. So that's what we can do. Yeah. I'll do more planning, but also get more input. The problem with doing too much planning ahead of time is that when I do that, then I'm basically coming in and I'm showing everyone what's happening, which I guess is fine, but I kind of like the idea of having participation and discussion. And I feel like if I just am doing something, then we're not going to get a whole lot of that. So, but the next one will definitely be more structured because we will have talked about it ahead of time. Exactly. Not breaking the magic. Every single one of those oohs and ums and and awkward pauses, they gotta stay. Two different desperation attacks. That's an interesting idea for the near fatal. So that way if they're above near fatal. That's a good idea. So maybe either two different ones or at least adjust the chances, because I don't have the time to go through and make a bunch more desperation attacks and find places to put them. But what I can do is adjust the odds based on near fatal. So maybe have it skip near fatal for the original and keep it at 1 in 16. And then if they're near fatal, then make it like 50% chance or something like that. And then disable the thing down here where it checks to see if it's already been done. Right here. How does that sound to everyone? Just use random other ones? All right. Are other people getting behind this? That is a good idea, Tenka. I don't know. We don't have the time or the space to put something like that in currently. But that's not a bad idea. That's not a bad idea, especially if we're tweaking the current system. But what we don't have is a bunch of space to stick that in there. But I'm hearing about using random other ones, so let's look at that, because why not make it branch? And so what we'll need to make it do is skip. What I'm thinking is we'll skip this. What we'll do is we'll just chunk all this code up a little bit. And then in the space where you know that this frees up plus where it checks for this here, we can have it check for near fatal and then adjust. And so if we keep them, especially if we keep the order of the attacks in the same order, then it should be a really easy transformation to make, and we should be able to keep it in here hypothetically. So I'm going to go ahead and launch USME. Open. Desperation Plus. And let's take a look and see what we got to work with. If you guys can't see this, let me know. Um, You can replace them with summons. What's going to be stronger? I guess it doesn't really matter for the time being. I mean, it would be nice, especially if we're going to be dropping this somewhere. If we're going to be releasing this as a partial patch for fun. Yeah, I know there's some free space. I would like to steer away from it as best as possible, though. Plus one. Yeah, we could do that. We could just have it increment. What does that mean for? Okay. It means ex medio, which is Go-Go's, I believe, would turn to takedown, which would be kind of funny. No, I don't mind just doing a plus one. I don't think I could do plus everything. Plus different amounts for different ones. Again, that requires a bunch of extra code, and we could potentially do for the final version, but for something for today, just jump everyone's ahead once isn't so bad. All right, we'll do that. We'll do that. And then testing it. I'm thinking if we increase the percentage of it happening also, we might need some more space too. So we may not be able to get away from needing space. That is a good idea, but that's a total overhaul. That is a total overhaul. I don't know if we're ready for that today. Not ready for that today. Maybe part two. Maybe in part two. All right, so let's start actually manipulating some of this code. So if you guys remember, I went over here and I grabbed all the code and I just plopped it in here so that we can do stuff with it. This is why. So what we're going to do is this near fatal bit right here, we're going to skip it. We're going to skip it, and we're going to pull all this stuff up. And one thing to make note of is when we do that, we're going to have to adjust all of these branches after that because we are basically pulling everything back. What is it, 5, 4, 5 bytes, something near fatal? Hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we're going to be jumping everything up 7 bytes here. So that means we're going to have to add 7 to every single branch the rest of the way down. 6, 10, yeah, is after we're done with all of our stuff. All right, so what we're gonna do, grab all this character already used to this combat. Okay, so this is what I need to do is just get rid of that. Get rid of that. And all these are gonna change and all that's gonna change, and then we're gonna take it down. Character already used this combat. The desperation test. All right. There we go. That's what we're doing. I like to leave some visual space so I can see where I did stuff. So this is coming out because we're no longer checking this. This is basically going away entirely. Yeah. If I had time for an 8-hour stream, because it back in my Uber hacking days, I would literally sit down for 8 hours and just like pore over code and do stuff. Right. And so we're also getting rid of this. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to delete it so I can see that there's space. Okay. All right. And then all these branches here, I need to add 7 to. Right. Is that what we came up with? Because that stays. Clear. Zombie stays. So B, we're talking C, D, E, F, 0, 1, 2. Seven is going to go up to 14, which is D, I think. 7 plus 7. So 8, 9, 10, 8, 9, A, B, C, D, E, E. That right? 8, 9, A, B, C, D, E. Okay. I always do these wrong. I always do this wrong the first time. In fact, my Monster AI upgrade patch that was broken from the time I left until the time I came back, so about 2 years. About half the reason it was broken was because it would have at least been functional, even if it was. It wouldn't have crashed the game, even if it wasn't checking properly, was because I had a bad branch in it. Anyway, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, wait, oops. Why did I even think that that was a thing? JSR, branch of not equal. Oh, 20 is going to be very easy to add 7 to. Okay. All right. All right, and so now we hypothetically have 7 and then whatever I deleted from here, which I don't remember now. It's going from 3 to 8, so it's only like five bytes. So we've got like 12 bytes to work with, and what we need to do, 2 long sad years. Yes. Sad for everybody. That's okay, they were necessary, and I'm back. All right. Hey, Smasher M3D. All right, so we are in the middle of adjusting some code here. And we decided that we were taking out the check for near fatal. And we're going to add it down here to adjust the desperation attack if you were near fatal. So, for hypothetically, for a future situation where you would have a more powerful one when you were closer to death. All right. So what that looked like was that. Okay. And instead of branch, what we're going to do. Oh shoot, you know what? This probably isn't even where we're going to put it because we want to wait until after we've calculated it. So let's cut that out. Decrement by 1, so now it's got all that stuff set. So this is where we're at right here. Store AB6. Right here is when we're at where we want to be. All right, so we're going to go back here. We're going to drop this code here. And I'm going to leave some space so we can see this is where we were doing stuff. Oh, come on. Bing, bing, bing. Bing, bing, bing. Where are we doing stuff? Where are we doing stuff? All right, we cut stuff out here. I'm just making visual markers. Just making visual markers. All right, and so now what we're doing, okay. So I'm actually going to have to probably push A because we don't want it to change. We just need to figure out whether we're going to increment it or not. So this might take a little bit more space than I was hoping. Anyone have an idea off the top of their head how we can check it without messing up what we've already got? I mean, we could load it, and I mean, it looks like X and Y are consistent all through here, so in fact, it's not using X. I could potentially push X and okay. What I could do is transfer A to X. I need to check on the registers to make sure we're working with the proper ones, but I could transfer A to X. Haven't you watched Game Theory? It's an aileron roll. Yeah, so what I'm thinking is I will transfer A to X. I need to look and see what the state of the registers is right here to make sure I can do this without messing stuff up. Is push X, transfer A to X, and then do this right here. And if it works, then it'll branch past the increment. Or if they're not near fatal, then it'll branch past the increment. And then the next line will basically just increment X. And then I transfer X back to A. Hold on one second. So this is going to take a few extra lines. Let's figure out how much space we're actually going to need, because we might need to wiggle some stuff around. So hypothetically, what we're looking at is currently right here, we have the value that we want to use. So if we transfer A to X, and then we need to push X first. We push X because we're going to want X to be back to what it was before we left. So we'll push X, transfer A to X, then come on, then we'll run this. So load A, this, we'll do a branch that's literally just going to be like branch 01. Oops, no, I want that to stay there. And then, oh, come on, what did I just do? What did I just hit? Page down? Of course, mistypes are a thing that happen all the time in this also. All right, let's get this out of here. Let's get this out of here. This is where it starts to look a little bit messy, but this is how I do hacking. I'm kind of keeping track of stuff, and then I kind of fill it in as I need to. Six, four, six, nine is free space branching. What do you mean by that? I took a look at that. The reason why I can't load A after the check is because right here, A is our value, unless you're talking about storing it here and then checking it. I guess I could do that if after it's stored, then checking for near fatal and incrementing it. And then just increment B6. 'Cause I can increment do I have the window up? I can increment a RAM address, can I? Wait, was I an increment? Here it is. Increment address. This right here, direct page, right? EDOY. What are we looking at here? What are we looking at here? Let me go back to C2. Let me go back to the original. Where's this 3EDO? 3EDOY. This is not coming up with anything. What are you trying to do? Is this case sensitive? I can rink on. Yeah. I didn't think of that. So yes, that is definitely better. Yeah. Okay. So that's what we're gonna do. Forget all this X crap. Forget all this X crap. We are going to push this off, kill this till after all this. Right, so after store AB6, this is where we're going to put it. This is where we want it. So that means this stuff's getting chopped out too, right? So that means that was another 5 bytes, I think, that got shoved up. Yeah, Gon and Maru don't get desperation attacks. I mean, we could hypothetically, even if they never get a chance to run the code because they don't do normal. Actually, I mean, Gaw technically does. I think in some of his rages have a normal attack in them. But yeah, that's a good point that we can use that for space. And Umaro, it would never run the code. And so basically, we would have just an ability that sits there. That's a good point. We might not need it. We might not need the space. But if we do, then we can go back and do that. Wow, we're already at almost 11 o'clock. I guess I knew that this is a long process, but like we're like actually in the thick of it now. I don't mind going over a little while. Not horribly late. Especially since for some people it is 4 o'clock in the morning and they're making an effort to be on the stream, so let's give them what they paid for. I don't think that's the right phrase here, but you know what I mean. All right, let's see how much space we need because we have 12-ish bytes to work with, and that means these branches also need to wait 1604. So that actually doesn't need to skip anything else. This one does though. So this one moved up, needs to move up 12, right? All right, 12. I'm sure some of these are going to be wrong, and we'll catch that on the debugger when we come back. That's all right, Matt. I appreciate you coming out if you got a bounce. Something happened with the sound? Did we lose something? No, mic's still going. Anyway. Where are we at? Where are we at? We just jumped down here. We were trying to bring this in here. And this is going to end up being 2. And right here, we're going to increment. Except ink isn't the wrong. It's the wrong one. I don't remember what it is. What's it look like? Okay, it is ink DP. That is the syntax. That just looks wrong to me. B6. Alright. See ya, Mad. Thanks for joining. Alright, so this is what we're trying to do here. So we're going to ink the direct page. Increment the direct page once we're done there. And what was the... E6. So we're doing E6, B6. E6, B6. E6, B6. Going to do ink B6. All right. All right, and that's all we have to do for that portion of the code. The only other one was if we were going to change this. So we actually currently don't need this space. The only other thing is if we were going to change this. But since we just went through all this, let's go ahead and see if we can get this change working. And probably call it a night there, because we already have this set to 100%, and we'll stick with that for now. So let's figure out what we need to do with the code to get that there. We're just chopping out a few bytes here. All right, so where we were at, this should be the first, should be down here somewhere. Yeah, D1 right here. Right. C903. And so, yes, this was the first part. Why does it say that should be? Oh, geez, we can cut this counter thing out too, right? Because we're not using the time counter. We're not using the time counter, right? But since we don't need a ton of space, I'm just gonna not process it. I'm just gonna go ahead and leave that as the not process, and then I'll just bump up the rest of this stuff, starting with DA, which is here-ish, 8924, and then we're jumping down to right here, and then we'll move all that up. Okay, so this 8924, we need to move ahead to B91830, right? And this is where we were testing that bit. So when we're not doing any of that now. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna control copy this. Control copy is not what I just did there. It's okay. And we're pulling it back to right about, we're pulling it back 7 bytes is what we did, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we're going to be right after those, not process. And control B, we'll just paste right. Okay. And we need to go back over the branches that we did. So that DO32 becomes 39. That DO2B becomes 3-2. That FO2E become, I mean 2-7 becomes 2-E. How many bytes do we add down here? I might leave the rest of that if I can. Well, I still need to move this up. Yeah. Exactly. So, I mean, ideally what I would like is that we would take it and make it a viable thing that you would have to work towards. So that way your character could go down the sword tech path, or they could specifically set themselves up to doing desperation attacks, and it would be viable. Hopefully not overpowered one way or the other, but yeah. But for tonight, we're just gonna make it happen more often. And then the one little tweak that we're adding is it incrementing which attack it's doing. All right, so where are we at? We just pasted this stuff in. We increased our branches. I still have one left here. This DO27. Oh no, that was one that we skipped. And I want to leave that space in there because we are going to go back and probably add that back in later. But for now, we're skipping that random stuff there. And then we're continuing on. All right, so then the next thing that needs to get copied up is B9D83E. So this is the stuff that we're overwriting. B9D83E. So all this stuff here, all the way down to 85B6, which isn't actually that far ahead. 85B6. So all this right here is backing up another 5-ish bytes. So I'm gonna leave. Actually, no, that's a lot more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 11, 12. Oh, right, because it's the first 7. And then, yeah. So that's hopping up here. And where are our branches in here that we have to take care of? That 05 becomes 05. Ah, I didn't rewrite those. Shoot. Or maybe, no, I didn't. The 05 becomes, exactly, flashing fight command. We were talking about potential ways to like display that it was ready when it was up. Anyway, I'm doing math here, so I've got to add 12. Got to add C to 5. So that's going to get me DEF 01, so it should be FO11. Let's do this over here. Let's do this over here. Oh no, because you're not jumping to C. That's why. That's why I skipped that one. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. That one doesn't need to change. I need to change this one, the one that's jumped to 610, which is BOOD. Adding C to that. The first one was 12. No. The first one I turns out I wasn't supposed to do anyway. Just this one that goes to 10, because that jumps down to the code where we're ending up later. Bring the calculator up. I feel like when I use the calculator, it ends up wrong. Oh, I was right the first time. All right, but what I'm doing now is I'm doing D plus C. So 19. And And that should be it. That should be it, right? The rest of those all stay the same. And then after 8-5-B6, I'm starting the rest of this. 8-5-B6. And let's go ahead and knock out a bunch of things until we get down to... ...1609. The A910 is where it's going to pick back up again. So all of our code is happening right here, and we're not using very much space. We're going to do this B9. So this is what we're putting in now. This is what we're putting in now. This is going to be an O2 because we're only skipping two things. So B9, E5, 3E, 8, 9, 02. O02. Oh, wait, except I don't want it to branch always. I don't want it to branch always. That was from when we were testing with it before. I need branch if not equal, right? I need branch if not equal. I'm going to go make sure I'm doing that right. What was the original? Branch if equal. Excuse me. FO. FO. So this is FO to branch people. Right? So if they're not near failure, it skips the increment. All right, so back over here. So 8902 FO02 E6B6. And I think that's it. I think that's it. It'll run every single attack because we took out the random chance. And if they're near fatal, then it'll move up a tick. All right, so that's what we're testing. That's what we're testing. And we're also going to make sure we hop into the debugging on this. And this documentation I normally clean up later on, so I understand that this is a little bit messy. This is what we're gonna do. Did I save? I did save. Okay. I'm gonna bring this back up. I'm gonna reload the game. And this is the next thing, too. Where is my little thing over here? Oh, wait, this is the RAM. I don't need this. All right, so I'm going to set a breakpoint for in here so that we can make sure we're tracking through the code so we can see these branches as they happen. So the first place it's going to vary is right after this, so I'm going to start my breakpoint right here at... Now I can't see it. C215D1. C215D1. On execute, read is for if it's reading a RAM address, and write is when it writes to a RAM address. So we're doing execute. So this is saying that this is code that we're doing a breakpoint on. All right, so we run. And I think it has to get there after... That was the not process. Yeah, so that was after the monster one, so it shouldn't run. We shouldn't get stopped every time a monster tries to do something. Okay. I've been told that before, actually. Alright, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to do the attack with Terra. Should get a brain. Okay, there we go. Alright, got a breakpoint. Alright, so what did we want this to look like? Step into. This stuff should all work. That stuff should all work. Oh, shoot. Actually, I'm not going to be able to test these without, I'm not going to be able to test these branches without actually setting these conditions. So hypothetically, this should probably just work. Right? Riot Blade. Yeah. Yeah, so that's just going to work. In fact, what I'm going to do is I'm going to kill this breakpoint. Because we're going to have to do separate testing for that. Well. So wait, are you saying I'm enjoyable or Sheldon is enjoyable? Because this is relevant information to me. Oops, you know, I hope I didn't kill myself. Okay, good. Yeah, from, oh, shoot. All right, now she should do Mirager, right? No, she did nothing. She did nothing. All right, turning the breakpoint back on. Ow, fudger nutter. Do I have any, I don't even have any. All right, well. Oh, hey. You made it. Is it Kuga? Kuga? My first instinct is to say Kuga, but I don't know if that sounds right. Kuga? You have a phonetical spelling you can put out there for me? Alright, hold on. I'm gonna reset this. Recent? No. There's reset game. Here we go. Alright, my breakpoint on. Breakpoint. Actually, breakpoint off. Because I want to see if I'm getting... Alright, so Mirager worked. Riot Blade worked. Now, it shouldn't work if you're attacking your party, which is fine. Oh wait, and I need to make sure that I can actually attack a second time also. So I'm going to save the game position here. You know what? It's still only letting me do it once a fight. I thought we skipped that out. Okay. See? This is what we do this for. Kuga. Okay. Kuga. Got it. Hold on just a sec, guys. Give me just a minute here. Be right back. Sorry about that, guys. And that's what the original code calls for. Oh, hey, came back. Awesome. Oh, I used a lot of nops. I thought I skipped the part. Where it checked if it had been done already. I thought I literally cut that out. Has it already been used as combat? This one right here. I chopped that out. In fact, I chopped all this out here. It should not even be checking this. Let me go back and check just in case I'm wrong. It's B91830. There it is. No, it's not. That's just a different thing. That's probably loaded again elsewhere. Yeah, we caught that earlier, that it was only once each battle, and we had disabled it. And so I thought that was still in place. But I seem to have not done that properly. Is that B9D83E? Let me kill this. I don't want anything else altering my hex. Did my stuff get reverted? Did my save not save? Well, that was my first thought, but I don't see how that could be a thing. Or unless I copied the wrong thing in here. Let me hop over here. Let me make sure that it matches what I actually did here, or potentially a bad branch. I don't think it should be following any of the branches, because most of those are exits, basically. Alright. 5d1. You know what? Let's. I don't know why I didn't just. I don't know why I didn't just run the debugger. Breakpoint C215D1. Is that right? Let's see if it's even running the code. Okay, it is. It is. Alright. Let's see where we're at. Oh my goodness. What is all this? Is that the rage quit button? What in the world? What in the world, Smasher? Alright, let's make sure this is following my code right. Oh, I'm saving it. I'm saving it locally. I am a Twitch noob, and so I do not know all the things that are doable. So, I do have a copy, and it's going to show up on the new and improved Final Fantasy VI Hacking.com YouTube channel. All right, so bit 24, checking for muddle. That should work fine. Why is there compare Y? Hold on. It's telling me. I just failed this check. It jumped to the right place, which is. No, wait. It couldn't have. I just failed this check. Is my chat having its first fight? Aw, this is sweet. Alright. So what it's looking like is it looks like I failed the check here that's saying that I'm muddled or have image. Pretty sure neither of those things is true. So we're going to hop into the RAM, take a quick look-see. We might have to... Where is this checking? Oh, hold on. I see what happened. The bit that was loaded for... the bit that's supposed to be loaded for... the near fatal is the same one that has muddle and image on it. And so when I took that out, when I cut that out, now it's checking whatever random bit is loaded in, it's checking this right here. And so, yeah, the bit happened to be set, and so now it's branching out. But I did manage to see that I have my branch set correctly for that one, so that's good at least. All right. That's what we did. That's what I did. Why didn't you guys catch that? That's what you're here for. Goodness gracious. Goodness gracious. Okay. All right. Kill it. Kill it. Kill it. Kill it. Go back here. I can fix that. Up at the beginning. But I actually do need to bump a bunch of stuff back down. Do need to bump a bunch of stuff back down for that. Right? 8924. I need to bump it down at least one. Let me skip the counter, but I didn't replace that, right? I need to bring this back right here, this B9E5E3E, because that's where it's checking near fatal, but it also checks for metal and image. You mean the one that I don't play, Smasher? The one that I've literally never, ever played? Yes. Yes, you can beat me in the game I've never played before. Good job. Yeah, you can copy insert with HXD. But when it does it, like, you always get weird errors. And I don't want to... It's going to be, like, another copy of it, and it won't automatically reset my branches. So I got to do that. You wish you could whoop me in Melee. You still can't handle Young Link. But that is neither here nor there. Alright. So I need to... It's a good thing I left all this extra space in here, too. I basically only need to drop these down one extra byte. I'm going to do that, and then I need to bring this load back. So that's B9E53E, and all these branches need to get pulled back 1, 3, 8, 3, 1, 2, D. All right, we're going to try that. I missed one. No, I didn't. Let me go over here. Where am I going? Oh. Yeah, this is the problem with running late. I need to... I'm going to need to go AFK again here for a moment. So, bear with me. Okay, I'm back. All right. Anyway. So I was making sure I had all my branches reset correctly. That 3.9 was became a 3.8. I did that. Right, 3.8. And then 3.1. 2E should have been a 2D. I'm sorry, 3D. That should be 2D. That should definitely be 2D. And this I skipped over, right? This is currently skipped over. It'll make an appearance again later. So I don't need to worry about that. All right. All right, so let's try this again. Let us try this again. Desperation, load position. It should. There we go. There we go. And let's load the position again. Because now we're going to go back and check to see if it did our increment. Yeah. Come on. Be near fatal already. Why is everyone hitting for 11? There we go. Why is every hit for 11? Yep, Mirager. There it is. There it is. And we have a working increment. Ta-da. Alright, so it's using the Desperation Attack every attack. And is my screen frozen? Is the picture of me frozen? Oh no, never mind. I was just like looking down for a long time. Delay. Oh, you guys are mean. You guys are mean. Look, success. Someone comment on this. All right. So the way we've currently got it, and it is working. We haven't checked all the branches yet, but I don't think we're doing that tonight. All right, so we've got it now where the desperation attack happens every attack. What I should probably do is at least put this back in, and then just have it check for a different number. And say I change that to like OC or something like that. And 1 to 12. Or 08, 0 to 8, could be a 50-50 chance. Thanks for acknowledging me. Thank you. I was starting to feel a little bit invisible. Oh man. Guys, I really can't turn this Twitch channel into a liability. So if you could please lay off the scams, it would be greatly appreciated. All right. So I think that's all we're gonna do tonight. I will set a date for the next one after I get a chance to look at my schedule. And what we'll do next time, I'll reassess how much free space we have, and I might move some stuff around, like organize it a little bit. And then come back with it a little bit cleaned up and with kind of a direction to go. We'll open up a thread on the forum about it. We'll figure out what direction we want to go with it and what changes we're going to do next. and we'll take step two towards making a revamped desperation system. So thank you guys all for coming out, and I appreciate this was a great turnout. This was actually better than I expected. I mean, when I first logged in, it was literally just me and Matt on here. MO6 said he was here, but he couldn't type. But anyway, I was like, okay, well, it was a fun idea anyway. And but here we are, and we've got a good, like, I don't know, 8 or 10 people on here. So this has been fantastic. I'm enjoying this. Dude, I learned Alt F4 back when I was in like high school. Just assume for a second that if you have any kind of technical knowledge, I have that and more, so you're not going to be able to not going to be able to one-up me on that. Sorry. Right, well, I hope you guys were able to learn something from that mess and were at least mildly entertained. I know I enjoyed it. So I'm going to do this again. And I hope you guys will join me as well. And we will see you next time. All right, thanks guys. Have a good one.